Hi, Bloggerheads. I have another story for you. It was 1979 or so. I was working as the mechanical bull mechanic on the set of the movie Electric Cowboy. I was with Deborah Winger and Robert Redford, if memory serves. Well, as it turned out, Miss Winger had a feminine rash situation going on in her privates. And so they asked me to rig a softer saddle for this mechanical bull. I was a mechanic. It was mechanical things were my nature, but rigging saddles didn't exactly fall under the purview of my job description. But what I did was I got a lot of cotton batting. You know, the stuff you put in upholstery and furniture to make it soft. I got a lot of cotton batting, and I put it in a brown chamois that matched the color of the saddle for this mechanical bull. Well, everything seemed great. Cotton batting worked well, but, you know, stunt people are often called in to check things out, and Deborah Winger had a stunt person to ride the mechanical bull. I got a little distracted. You know, it's a bar situation. For those who aren't familiar or have forgotten the movie, it's a Texas-style bar with a mechanical bull. And I had gotten so distracted by the demands of making this soft cotton batting saddle that I neglected to properly check the mechanics inside the mechanical bull, and one of the motors burned a little hot, and there was a fire. Now, normally this is not a big deal, except if you have a rigged mechanical bull with a whole lot of cotton batting piled up as a saddle, which caught fire. Now, normally on the set of a movie, if you are aware that you're doing a fire scene, you have extinguishers and wet blankets and people on hand to specifically put out the fire, but nobody expects a bar scene involving a mechanical bull to end in flames. And as a result, we weren't prepared. Now, I suppose beer would have been the next best thing. Believe it or not, beer is not what was thrown. As it so happens, some people decided that throwing tequila might put out the fire. You can imagine. Stunt woman was engulfed in flames. And she leapt off and ran out the door, akin to the scene where King Denethor, in the Lord of the Rings movie Return of the King, runs out of the crypt and books it the whole entire length, must have been half a mile, of the top tower of Gondor to jump off the ledge. Well, this woman ran across the whole bar, much like King Denethor, on fire, and outside, and rolled in the dirt, because if she had rolled on the floor of the bar, it was straw and peanut shells and wood, she might not have successfully put out the fire in that situation, plus all the people, a few spilled drinks here and there. Well, she got out there and she rolled around, and we did put the fire out, and she only had second-degree burns and lost her hair, of course, well compensated by the movie company, and I was laid off that set. Doing something that wasn't even in my job description. Those fuckers. Those fucking fuckers in the movie business. I don't know why the hell I do these things. Why do I devote my talents to Hollywood? They don't appreciate it. They ask you to do stuff that's not in your job description, and then you get fucked for it. That's what happened to me, folks. McGrawTim. Signing off trepidatiously. As a side note, about 3 or 4 years later, I was hired by the Pepsi-Cola company. company. They were doing a fancy-ass, high-budget production commercial. And the set involved a concert stage. They wanted me to maintain the mechanics of the speakers and the light show and the various equipment that was on stage, because they had spent a great deal of money to hire a prominent singer to croon the praises of Pepsi Cola. Might have heard of this singer. His name was Michael Jackson. Now hold on. I don't feel comfortable letting these stories lie where they are. I had acquired a bit of a reputation at that point, and I was made an offer for a movie in production of a Stephen King novel starring Drew Barrymore called Firestarter. I showed up for work that day, and I assured them that the entire movie would be flame-free. They fired me on the spot. You just can't fucking win, Hollywood.